Hi guys, Martin here with build update number 4 for my Monogram 148 scale F-4C Phantom. So what have I done since update number 3? Well, at update number 3 I painted the plane except for the underside of the tail where the exhausts are, which are all bare metal. So I did that and painted the leading edges. The AIM-7 Sparrow missiles, which were all white, I thought looked boring, so I decided to put a couple of stripes on each of them and some grey tips on the front ends. And then after that I gave the plane and the missiles a clear coat, then I decaled everything. It says on the instruction sheet, on the decal sheet, 161 decals, but there's a lot more than that because some of those decal numbers have multiple decals per that number. For instance, on the leading edge of the wings, you've got the no step. Well, there's probably about 8 of those on each of the front leading edges. So you've got multiple decals per number in instances taking the decals over 200. So I put all the decals on, took me 2 days to do that, bloody long time, and that's it. I've done all that, and last night before I went to bed I sealed everything in with a clear coat, so everything's set now, ready for me to move ahead with weathering and doing some panel line highlighting, some bleaching, tonal variations and staining, etc. I also assembled the AIM-9 missile carrier racks onto the pylons, and I assembled the wheels onto their axles, front and underwing wheels. So let's show you where we're at. So here's the plane first. She's all sealed with decals. And let me take these cocktail pin pegs out. As you can see, there's a ton of decals everywhere. This is the largest one. These I painted the red and white stripes on the wingtips, but I used the decal because of being angled and going around contours. I just didn't fancy attempting painting those stripes. But as you can see, there's a lot of decals in this area around the cockpit. On that wing and the tail, and as you can see I painted the underside of the tail where the exhaust, so I fitted the exhaust and I did some tinting there, some blue tinting on both sides, give it that heat burned look. And when I do some weathering I might put some soot on there as well, so I'm not finished yet. I also put the orange tip on the tail fin, and that also goes onto the horizontal stabs. On the underside again you can see there's tons of little decals under there that I had to put on. So that's where we are. Show the next, the horizontal stabs. This only has decals on the top. But as you can see, orange tips on both of those stabs that I put on. And then this is the carrier racks for the AIM-9 sidewinders. I've fitted those to the pylons and then I painted the leading edge on their dark green because that's exposed when that goes in its position, just to match the dark green above it on the camouflage. I just painted the tip. And on the port side wing, it's got the brown on the front leading edge, because that's gonna sit under there, under the brown. I've not assembled the sidewinders onto those pylons yet, because they're gonna be airbrushed with a satin finished, as with the nose on the aircraft. The rest is matte. So what I'll do is when I finished everything and I airbrush the matte varnish, finishing coat on everything, I'll matte varnish these. I'll satin varnish the missiles, then I'll assemble the missiles last and put them in place. Missiles. Show you they're all decaled now. You can see the decals on there. There's four, there's one there, one there, one there, and one on the tip. There's four on each of the four aims, so that's 16 decals on those four missiles. And then on the sparrows, as you can see, I did a grey tip and put a yellow stripe and a brown stripe, and then I put the decals on there as well. There's only two decals on the sparrows. There you go. I think they look better with a bit of colour on them. Just to tart them up a bit, make them look a little bit fancier. So that's it regarding paint. Oh, and the wheel assemblies. There you go. I assembled the wheels, so they're ready. They just need a gloss coat so I can do some weathering on there. Put a wash on them. What else? Okay, what have I got next? Oh, I've got the these are the hydraulic cylinders. They're ready to go. They go in the undercarriage bays. The undercarriage bays, I have to take these doors off that were temporarily located with plasticine, three doors each side, and I have to gloss varnish inside the undercarriage bays and inside the doors so I can do a wash on those. These rear doors are red inside, so that they have to be airbrushed red and then sealed and washed. And that's about it, what I have left to do, and just the final assembly of all the undercarriage pieces, the ordnance and everything. Anything I came across? No, just the decals. And on the decals, can get a bit confusing. So be careful when you're doing the decals. They have decals that are missing. There's a few missing, which are numbered on here, but they're not on the sheet. Or they are on the sheet, but the right quantity's not there. There was a decal that required four, and there was only two, so I had to leave two off. Another one where there was two, and there was only one on the sheet, and I could show you that one. On the undercarriage door there, there's a caution sign. Well, there was only one of those, so I couldn't put it on the other undercarriage door. So there are things to look out for. You can make the decision to leave the one off so that both doors look like they got nothing on. And that's it, I think. So it's just down to weathering now, staining, washing, final assembly, and putting the canopy in place as well. I haven't painted the canopy yet. That's going to be within the next build stage. So the next build update will be my final reveal. So this is my final build update. The next will be the final reveal, guys. So thanks for following along. I'm going to leave you guys now. Keep up the great work. I'm loving your videos, and I'm signing out. See you in a few days. Tally-ho, chocks away. Wait. We'll be right back.